Dear brothers and sisters, I welcome you all to hear and see this video message. In this video, we are going to pray for deaf disabled community in India. This article I wrote on 31st March 2020 and my suggestion already I sent to our union government through citizens portal mygovernment.in. Content for this video I given in the description, you can go through and study. The 2011 Indian census cities roughly 1.3 million people with hearing impairment. Contrast that to numbers from India's National Association of the Deaf, which estimates that 18 million people, roughly 1% of the Indian population, are deaf. Even that would be surprisingly low considering that 3.5% of the Americans and 5% of the world population experience hearing loss. The wide range in population estimates exist because the Indian census does not track the number of deaf people. Instead, it documents an aggregate number of people with disabilities. The estimates vary according to how deaf is defined. The Indian deaf population is not well connected or informed, and many deaf people do not even know the names of all the schools or clubs for the deaf within their own city. World Health Organization definition of deafness refers to the complete loss of hearing ability in 1 or 2 years. The cases includes in this category will be those having hearing loss more than 90 decibel in better ear or total loss of hearing in both the ears. The World Health Organization definition of hearing impairment refers to both complete and partial loss of ability to hear. Persons with Disability Act 1995 states that hearing impairment is a disability, and a person with disability means a person suffering from not less than 40% any disability as certified by a medical authority. In addition, in Section 2, hearing disability has been defined as a hearing disabled person is one who has the hearing loss of 60 decibel or more in the better ear for conversational range of frequencies. The high burden of deafness globally and in India is largely preventable and avoidable. As per World Health Organization, about 80% of all deafness can be avoidable. It has also been stated by the World Health Organization that there is a shortage of human resources to address the issue of deafness. The estimated number of otologists in India are only 2,000. The audiometrist population ratio was found to be 1:5 lakh, and the ratio of speech therapists to the deaf population was 1:200 as on 2016. There is also a misdistribution of personnel with more people located in urban than rural areas. Human resource analysis revealed that there is a need to enhance the skills and working capacity of practicing doctors and other personnel. In 1920, there were 10 schools for the deaf in India. At present, there are 478 schools receiving government funding, and approximately 372 private schools for the Indian deaf are scattered throughout India. 4 in every 1,000 children suffer from severe to profound hearing loss, with over 1 lakh babies that are born with hearing deficiency every year. In India, hearing disability was the second and most common cause of disability. Hearing impairment is a serious but grossly neglected condition in India. So the country also suffers a huge economic impact due to lost productivity, higher unemployment and lower wages for the hearing impaired. The real issue in India is the woeful inadequacy of facilities of any type for the deaf. Hearing loss is often not detected until a child is 2, 3 or even 4 years old, especially in rural areas, due to the poor awareness about deafness and its relation with speech and language development, as well as lack of infrastructure such as the non-availability of END surgeon, audiologist, audiological equipment and speech therapist. There is clearly a need for universal newborn hearing screening program in India. The neonatal and infant hearing screening programs can eventually improve the linguistic and educational outcomes for the child. The importance of a screening program is to provide effective treatment at the earliest opportunity, thereby reducing suffering due to the impairment. Also, exhort the pediatrician community in India to give hearing screening the same level of importance as vaccination. Thus, focus should be on early detection of newborn hearing loss and intervention. Deafness means loss of hearing and it may be partial or total. Hearing impairment cannot be seen and hence its effects are not visible to others, so deaf suffers in silence. Unlike blindness, deafness often provokes ridicule rather than sympathy. A deaf person is so isolated from family and friends and greeted by unsympathetic attitude, he is often depressed and needs psychological counseling. The consequences for a child born with hearing loss are quite severe. It is well established that a child with hearing loss cannot develop speech and language abilities. This puts the child at disadvantage in school, higher education, and limits future professional opportunities. The problem of the child deaf from the birth is quite different from that of the adult who has become completely deafened after school age or in adult life. The hard of hearing person whose deafness has developed slowly over the years is different again.